Good morning, students. Welcome to English online classes. Today I am with you with a new topic, new chapter, and the title of that chapter is Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. It gives me immense pleasure to explain about such a legendary figure to my students, and it will become our duty to follow what he did for us. The qualities Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel known for are we are going to learn his qualities, the qualities he possessed. The first one is mental toughness and physical strength. That means he was mentally strong and physically fit. Next one is he is known for his major role in struggle for India's freedom. Third one is his unwavering commitment for national integration. That means he played a major role, a crucial role, or a significant role in the struggle for India's freedom. Next one is unwavering commitment. Unwavering means resolute, or we can say firm. Commitment for national integration means he did a lot to integrate more than 500 princely states of India. Next is that he had he possessed political foresight, great wisdom. Political foresight means that having foresight means to predict what is going to happen in future, and great wisdom means that he was intelligent enough to decide or to take fine decision for the sake of our country. So these are the qualities for which he was known as the Iron Man of India. Now we'll study in detail what he did and how his life was. Let's start. He was born on 31st October in a Gujarati family. 31st October 1875 in a Gujarati family. In his family he had three elder brothers and a younger brother and a sister In his childhood he displayed remarkable courage, and it can be learnt by this incident of his life. Once he, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, had a boil in his armpit. And at that time, a person suffering from the boil was taken to a man, and the man used to put a heated iron rod on the boil to treat that. So Patel was taken to that particular man, and he was reluctant. The person who used to treat the patient was unwilling to treat him. Keeping this in mind, that he was a child and he will not be able to bear the pain that was going to cause due to that rod. Seeing this, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel took the rod himself and put that on the armpit and treated himself. Such was his courage. Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel grew up to be a barrister. He worked hard and earned lot of money. After that, he came in contact with Mahatma Gandhi, and he got impressed with the theories of Mahatma Gandhi and his working. And after getting inspired from him, from Mahatma Gandhi, he decided to devote himself for India's freedom. He started working for the freedom of the country, and soon he rose to have a prominent position in that party, in the group of the people working for the struggle of India. And he became famous for what he did to save the peasant from the brutal policies of the British in Bihar through Bardoli Satyagraha. Again, he became a famous figure working for the freedom of India. After that, Sardar worked for women empowerment. He worked for women empowerment. That means he fought to help the women get their right. Empower means to empower someone, means to give power to him or her. So he worked for the women empowerment, and he also worked to abolish untouchability and discrimination. He worked for women empowerment, and he worked to abolish untouchability and discrimination. After that, what he did, I'm just going to explain. You can take your time. He took part in Quit India movement and civil disobedience movement led by Gandhi. He influenced the crowd so much that the people were not ready to pay taxes. Impact of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel on the people gathered there was great. So when he delivered a speech there, they were so influenced by him that they were ready to boycott taxes and even in taking part in civil services. Next, I am going to tell you that strikes and revolutionary activities, strikes and revolutionary activities forced the British to leave India. In this way, India got independence, but after independence, there was a huge problem. What the problem was that at that time India was divided in three parts. The first part was that was governed by the British themselves. The second one was that the people in that part were governed by the hereditary rulers, and the third was under Portuguese. In this way, it became necessary for Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel to realize his dream of uniting India, of unifying India. He wanted to see India as a whole, as one. So in order to do that work, he actually started struggle for that also. He realized that without unifying all the princely states, it will not be possible for India to maintain the freedom. So this uphill task was done by him. It was not an easy cake for him, but his relentless appeals and untiring efforts brought fruit, and India was unified by his efforts. Now these are the works that were done by this freedom fighter for India. In 1950, his health started declining means his health started deteriorating, that means worsening. He was taken to a hospital where he regained his health. But in the same year, on December 15, he had a massive heart attack. Due to that attack, he passed away. This legendary figure passed away on 15th December due to that massive heart attack. After his death, means posthumously, he was awarded with India's biggest civilian award, Bharat Ratna. Bharat Ratna, and his birthday, that means 31st October is celebrated as Rashtriya Ekta Divas or Rashtriya Ekta Divas or National Unity Day. This was about Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, and to know about him is really fruitful and worthwhile for all of us, not only for you but also for me, and it is our duty to follow his principles and how he was full of patriotism and sacrifice. We should understand that, and we should follow him. We should keep such a legendary figure in our mind. I hope you have understood the chapter clearly, and you will be able to write the exercise yourself. If any problem is still there, you can contact to me. Thank you for watching and keep learning.